Let us learn a new trick of faster math right away. By the way, this new trick that you're about to learn will be the foundation of many more tricks you'd be learning from here on. So watch closely. How fast can you multiply 23,212 with 3? I'm giving you 5 seconds for that. So your time starts now. Your time is up. The correct answer would be 69636. Right, so let's see if, 69636. Right, I'm sure you must have got the same answer. What I'm concerned with this time is not the answer that you got, but how you got it. So let's first see the usual way of doing it. The usual way of multiplying 2, 3, 2, 1, 2 with 3, or for that matter, any number with any other number, as we have learnt in school, is this. 3 2 times is 6, 3 1 times is 3, 3 2 times is again 6, 3 3 times is 9, and 3 2 times is 6. Alright? Well, if this method is what you use to find the answer, then I'm sure by now you must have spotted the inherent disadvantage of this method. That is, it gives us the answer from right to left. That is the least significant digit first. Now, the disadvantage of that is that we have to wait right till the end before we can start seeing the answer. Isn't it? First you'll find 6, then you'll find this 3, then you'll find this 6, then you'll find this 9, then you'll find this 6, and then only you can start seeing the answer, that the answer is 69636. Isn't it? So any method that can help us find the answer from left to right, like this, that is the most significant digit first, would immediately skyrocket our speed. Isn't it? You can straight away start seeing the answer. The answer would be 69636. As simple as that. And that is precisely what we will be learning right now in the faster way. So let's check out the faster way of doing it. The faster way of multiplying would be from left to right. You multiply each and every digit with 3. Alright? So 2 3 times is 6. 3 3 times is 9, 2 3 times is 6, 3 1 times is 3, and 3 2 times is 6. So your answer is 6 9 6 3 6. Alright? So you don't even have to write that. Immediately you can start saying the answer. Moment you see the question, you will say the answer would be 6 9 6 3 6. See? So simple it is. You have just seen that I have not done anything drastically or dramatically different here, have I? All I have done here is little tweaking or tuning to make the existing method go faster. Alright? And now you know the secret of faster math. The secret of faster mental math is the ability to multiply from left to right. Alright? And you'll see that your speed will become better and better with more questions you practice. Okay, so let's see more examples. Now you find out what is 121120 times 4. So again, from left to right, start multiplying each and every digit with 4. So 1 4 times is 4, 2 4 times is 8, 1 4 times is again 4, 1 4 times is again 4, and 2 4 times is 8. And 0 into any number is 0, so I'll put 0 here. So your answer is 484480. Alright? Do the next one. So, from left to right, multiply each and every digit with 7. So, 3 7 times is 21. Now, 1 7 times is 7. 2 7 times is 14. But you know that only one digit can come here, so not a problem at all. Carry forward one, write 4 here. Okay, now 6 7 times is 42. So write 4 here, 2 here. 3 7 times is 21. So write 2 here, 1 here. Now add all the numbers. So it would be 2, 1, 7 plus 1 is 8, 4 plus 4 is 8, 2 plus 2 is 4, and 1. That is what the answer is. Okay? Okay, so what is this? So 5 6 times is 30, 7 6 times is 42, 6 6 times is 36, 7 6 times is 42, and 6 1 times is 6. Now add the digits from left to right. So 3, 4, 3 plus 2 is 5, 6 plus 4 is 10. So write 1 here, 0 here, and then 2, and then 6. So the answer would be 3, 4, 6, 0, 2, 6. Alright? But then I would certainly like to avoid this step. I never do this step. This can be easily avoided. How? Let's see. See, basically, while I'm adding the digits, I'll put 3 here. Now I'll add 4 to 0. Okay? Now before I put down the answer as 4 here, I'll have a look what would be the digit sum of the next digit. If it is less than 10, then I'll copy this digit as it is. Okay? 4 plus 0 is 4. All right? Now 3 plus 2 is 5. But before I put 5 here, I'll have a look if the digit sum of the next digit is less or more than 10. Alright? So here in this case it is 10 only. So what I do is simply add 1 to 3 plus 2. Alright? 3 plus 2 would be 5 and 5 plus 1 is 6. And here I just put the units digit of the sum. So 6 plus 4 is 10. So the units digit is 0. So I put 0 here and 2, 6. That is what the answer is. The logic here is very simple. See, the digit sum like 6 plus 4 is 10. So it's always one that is carried forward to the left, isn't it? Take any digit sum like 6 plus 8. The answer would be 14, isn't it? So again, one would be carried forward to the left, and on the right, this unit's digit would be copied. Maximum digit sum would be 9 plus 9, isn't it? Digit can't be more than 9. So 9 plus 9 is 18. Again, what will be carried forward towards the left would always be 1. So that is what I do. I just have a look if the next digit would be add up to more than 10. Then if it does, if it's 10 or more, then I add 1 to this. Otherwise, I just copy the sum as it is. Now let's take smaller numbers. Why to always take huge numbers, isn't it? So take smaller numbers. What is 32 times 8? Alright. So again, 3 8 times is 24 and 2 8 times is 16. So write 1 here, 6 here. 24 plus 1 is 25. So the answer is 256. See, it works so well, isn't it? What would 1 2 2 1 1 times 13 be? All right. So 1 13 times is 13. 2 13 times is 26. Again, 2 13 times is 26. 1 13 times is 13. And 1 13 times is 13. Now add the digits. It would be 1. 3 plus 2 is 5. And the next digit sum is less than 10. So no problem. Copy 5 as it is. 6 plus 2 is 8. And have a glance at the next digit sum. So it is less than 10. So put 8. 6 plus 1 is 7. And the next digit sum is less. So no problem. 3 plus 1 is 4. 3. This is what the answer is. Now here I have assumed that you know the table of 13. But what if you don't know the table of 13? Though I would very strongly recommend that you must know multiplication tables till 20. But what if you don't know? Don't worry about it at all, because the trick that you're about to learn next would take care of that. In fact, that trick is so good and so fast that even those people who know the multiplication tables till 20, I'll recommend that you use that trick instead of